We have the trophies from the past and we have the talents for the future.
Ice is very important for the history of Dutch football.
I'm always proud to say I'm an Ajax supporter.
The identity of a club is really important. We're not a buying club. We're a club that focuses on producing young players.
The youth academy is really the base of the club. Without it, it would be nothing.
We give a lot of opportunity for the youth players, you know, to come into the first team, to get a chance to develop, to make mistakes.
If you see our team now, we have a lot of young players out of the youth academy, so it's going well.
Our youth academy always, throughout the years, produces the best players we ever had. Without it, we wouldn't be as successful as we are now.
I'm not afraid to give people an opportunity to start playing. And then if you're good enough, it doesn't matter how old or young you are, you get in the team.
From the last 20 years, the players it produced, the most important are Kluivert, of course, Frank and Ronald de Boer, Rafael van der Vaart,
Mark Overmars, Edgar Davids, Clarence Seedorf, or before that Frank Rijkaard, Marco van Basten, or before that Johan Neeskens and Johan Cruyff. We like to have players as long as possible, but nowadays we lose players a little bit too early, and I think our main focus is maintaining, keeping that talent for a longer period at the club.
TIPS is the program that Ajax still works with in the youth academy. It's four basic principles that the club philosophy is based on.
It's technique, insight, personality and speed. And it's the four things where you are rated on.
The four key points in the development of a player.
Few foreign players are now at the club. We have Edwin van der Sar, of course, the legendary keeper of Man United. And we have Mark Overmars, the former winger of Arsenal.
This is something from the last 5 or 6 years more, with Johan Cruyff getting more influence in the youth academy. Now you see a lot of players, Dennis Bergkamp, Jaap Stam, Ronald de Boer, also other strikers less known but still important in the Ajax history.
Players who've been everywhere, had success in football at Ajax, in England, in Italy, to also have that knowledge to come back, to flow back to the club and give that now to the young players who've seen my career or Frank de Boer's career, Mark Overmars. Those are great examples for our players.
It's great for a young guy when you can work, you are a defender and Jaap Stam will tell you what to do or what you shouldn't do.
It's really nice to have those legends as a coaches. Yeah, the first times it's a little crazy, but after a while, yeah, you're getting used to it, and it's kind of normal that Frank de Boer and Dennis Bergkamp are training.
We always try to play attractive football, try to dominate the game.
In the 1960s, when Rinus Michels took over and Johan Cruyff came in the squad, and we just happened to have the best squad in Europe at the time, and they started playing this really fantastic attacking football that was really, yeah, innovative. Afterwards they called it total football, but at that time it was just best football in the world.
We always want to be the best, and we were a lot of times the best, but the pressure is that, you know, you always have to win.
The memory of 95 when we won the Champions League really with 9 or 10 of our own players was incredible, because nobody at the start of that season really expected it.
In the mid-90s we had so many young players, and we had a coach, a very demanding coach.
It was a combination with homegrown players, experienced players and Louis van Gaal.
It drove us to certain heights that I think nobody expected from ourselves. At that time only 3 foreign players were allowed. So we had a very tight bond as a players, and did a lot of things together. That was a period that was unbelievable for the club, for Amsterdam, and I think also for Holland.
For Dutch football, Ajax is the most important club. I mean, won the most titles, have the most prestige in international football.
It's the biggest club in Holland, and a lot of supporters, and every game the stadium is full, and yeah, they're making a lot of noise, and they love Ajax, and it's nice to play for them.
Ajax fans are well known for their critical vision on their own team, and that's sometimes something you see in the stadium as well. You have the Fuck 14 who are always supporting and always chanting.
They're real crazy, and they're always at every game away and home, and yeah, they're making a lot of noise with firework and everything, and yeah, it's just crazy to play for the guys, and they love Ajax, and yeah, it's just amazing.